worse than that. Well, you're wrong. It does. Let me tell you the worst person in my family. The worst person in my family is my cousin Al. I'll tell you why. My cousin Al was on drugs too. But unlike my dad, Al found Jesus. See, but Al's one of those people that found Jesus, and now that he found Jesus, he tries to throw Jesus on everybody. You ever meet somebody like that? For no reason at all, they throw religion at you. You did nothing to deserve this conversation. No matter what you say, they bring up religion. Hey, good morning, Al. It is a good morning, because Jesus woke us up. Hello. Boom. I love him. Do you? What? The fuck does that have to do with anything, man? I'm trying to play basketball. This ain't got shit to do with nothing. Al got mad at me because I live in L.A. He said, Kevin, you out here in Hollywood doing God knows what? Sex? Drugs? Money? Lord knows what you're into. Need to get a relationship with God. I said, dude, don't talk to me about God. I'm fine, okay? You're the one who's on drugs. You get a relationship with God. He got mad. Now, anytime he get mad, he always got to bring up some dark shit from his past that nobody needs to know. Out of nowhere, he said, Kevin, let me tell you something. I know I was on drugs, but I found Jesus. Granted, I didn't know him when I was out there sucking dick for money, but I'll tell you something.
I said, wait a minute. First of all, you're not going to speed past that like you didn't just say what you just said. I said, what was this? What year was this? He said,
it was in the 80s. Everybody was doing it. This is shit that pissed me off. He said, your dad was back there with me.
I said, what?
My dad was like, all right. Hey, you gonna learn today?
No, the fuck I'm not.
You gonna keep that lesson to yourself.
I told my dad to go get one cup and put your name on it. That is your cup. You're gonna drink out another goddamn glass in this house. That's it for you.
Al was a different ball game, man. Al single-handedly destroyed my mom's funeral. Al, here's the thing. My mom, first of all, I'm going to be honest with y'all. My mom passed away 5 years ago, okay? Now, my mom died from cancer. At the time, was it difficult? Yes. But me and my brother, we got through it. We knew it was coming, so we prepped ourselves. We're at the funeral. Funeral's almost over. Pastor gets up. He says, would anybody like to say any words on Nancy's behalf? It's quiet. Nobody says nothing. All of a sudden, my cousin Al gets up. He said, I got something I need to say. You can hear everybody in my family suck their teeth. Shit. God damn it. Shit. I cannot make this up. This is the speech that my cousin gave at my mom's funeral. Word for word. He comes to the podium. He said,
before I say anything, I just want to start off by saying, God is good all the time.
Now, when people say that in return, you're supposed to say, and all the time, God is good. Nobody said nothing. Listen, look, when I say it again, just be quiet. Don't nobody say shit. I want to show y'all how mad he got. Don't make me laugh. Just be quiet, okay? I want to show y'all how fucking mad he got. All right, don't make me laugh. Stop. This is exactly what he did. He said,
before I say anything, I just want to start off by saying God is good all the time.
Oh, don't nobody know what the fuck they're supposed to say back to Jesus? Say it back to Jesus.
My grandmom got scared. She was like, God is good all the time. She started messing it up. God is good all the time. Sometimes he's not. I don't say nothing about it. I just take Jesus.
Look, my grandmom is the king of fake pass outs. Like, she'll pass out for 3 seconds and wait and then peek to see if anybody looking. Take Jesus. Grandma, I saw you. Come on, get up. Get your ass up. Get your old faking ass up, grandma. You ain't pass out.
Here's the rest of the speech. Word for word is the rest of the speech. He goes,
before Nancy died, she owed me $53 and some change. Now, Kevin, real quick, how does that work? Does that roll over to you? Do I get it from you? Or
whatever, we'll figure it out. We'll talk about it.
Life is funny, ain't it? Sometimes when people die, you gotta laugh.
Hey!
I love you, Nance. Peace!
This nigga walked off like it was a concert. We was like, what the fuck? Wait a minute!
Now, before y'all judge my family, let me tell you how crazy this funeral got, okay? First of all our families are crazy. We just come in different races, shapes, and sizes. Now, at any funeral you go to, there's always one person at the funeral that's there to avenge the death of whoever died. They want payback. That person was my Uncle Richard Jr., okay? Now, all my real Kevin Hart fans know who my Uncle Richard Jr. is. For those who don't know, say it with your chest. That's my Uncle Richard Jr., all right? Now, like I said, my mom died from cancer. Everybody knows this except my Uncle Richard Jr. Funeral's over. Everybody's outside, they're consoling one another. It's a really emotional time. I'm talking. My uncle comes up, taps me on the back. He said, Kevin, I just want to let you know whoever did this is going to die tonight. Excuse me? What do you mean? What are you saying? I'm just trying to tell you, I'm about to peel this motherfucker's muffin cap back blue tonight, nigga! I said, cancer did it. It was cancer. He said, well, you tell cancer I'm looking for him, and when I find him, I'm gonna shoot him in the face. Twice. Me. By myself. One gun. One bullet. All day. Every day. Wake up. Go back to sleep. Take a nap. You ready to go night-night, nigga? You ready to go night-night, nigga? Everybody go night-night, nigga? I said, okay. I said, I can't. I said, dude, I can't do this. I can't. I said, you gonna tell him by yourself. I can't. Reason why I couldn't, it was time for me to be a pallbearer, okay? Now, here's the thing. It was time for me to go be a pallbearer. I had to go pick up the casket. We had to carry the casket down the aisle, put the casket in the hearse. Now, I've never been a pallbearer before. I've been offered several pallbearer positions, but I've turned them all down. Reason why I've turned it down, I'm small. I got little arms. My biggest fear is that you're gonna put me next to somebody that's tall with long arms. They gotta make up for the space. I gotta hold the casket up here. I fuck around, get tired, my arms start shaking, I drop it. Everybody look at me like, why you drop it? I'm like, I never had it. I'm like, yes you did. I'm like, no I didn't. I thought we was gonna pick it up on three. Nobody counted. Y'all assumed I had it. I didn't have it. My hand hurt. I thought it was gonna bleed. Whatever. I don't wanna be in that situation, but for this time, I don't have a choice. It's my mom. It's my mom's funeral, so I have to do it. So, I'm on the right side. I got the casket over here. My brother's on the left side. He's got the casket over there. Keep in mind, it's my mother, and it's a funeral, so I'm emotional. I'm crying. I'm a mess.
No. No. She wasn't ready. She wasn't ready.
So, this is why my dad's asshole. My dad see me crying. My dad stood up. Punch me in the back of the head. Stop being a bitch. Man up. She gone. I said, nigga, that's it, man. Fuck this shit, man. I forgot where I was. I threw the casket. When I threw it, my cousin Al stood up. He was like, it should have been me, Lord. I was the one sucking dick for money. my dad was like, all right, all right, all right.
Hey, you're gonna learn today.
Shut the fuck up, Dad. My grandma passed out sucking dick. Grandma, get you peeking, Grandma. Go. Somebody get Grandma ass out the church. Lying in front of God.